Hello everybody and welcome to another lesson from Mr. Sack's online resources. Today we'll be looking at the Year 7 to 8 Australian curriculum, focusing on aspects of the science strands, science understanding, science as a human endeavour, and science as an inquiry skill. We'll be investigating the effects of the human activity on local habitats by looking at particular environmental issues in society today. There we will consider the broader implications on the sustainability of ecosystems and the environment, looking at both the positive effects and the negative ones. And finally, we will look at current initiatives and consider how these solutions solve the various elements of the issue. There is a contemporary environmental issue up for debate in Australia, and the rest of the world for that matter, which centres around deforestation. There are those who argue that cutting down trees provides humanity with many of the world's resources, and a staple part of the global economy. However, within the scientific community, it is an undeniable fact that deforestation has severe adverse effects on our planet's environment and ecosystems, and is a key contributor to changing climate. But before we look at the effects of deforestation, we must understand the concepts of climate change and sustainability. Throughout history, the Earth's average temperature has remained largely stable, fluctuating no more than half a degree over 500-year spans. However, recently, the world has undergone a rapid increase in global temperature. The International Panel on Climate Change have calculated an increase of 0.85 degrees Celsius over the last 132 years. While the figure itself may not seem significant, the consequences it equates to definitely are. The atmosphere and ocean have warmed, the amounts of snow and ice have diminished, and sea level has risen, having widespread impacts on human and natural systems. The cause of this rapid change has been attributed to anthropomorphic activity and is the process that we refer to as climate change. The concept of sustainability, defined by the United Nations, is the ability to meet the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. This means to interact with the environment in a way that avoids depletion or degradation of natural resources and allows for long-term environmental quality. So what is deforestation and how is it interconnected with climate change? Deforestation is the process of mass clearing or removal of trees in areas densely populated by trees and other plant life. While this can happen due to natural causes, it is usually the result of deliberate human activity. The main reason for deforestation include clearing land for mining, clearing land for housing and development, farming the timber for use as a resource, and pasture for livestock and crops. The most notable is the use for the beef industry, being responsible for 75% of all clearing. The beef industry is also responsible for 77% of agricultural water use, but that's an issue for another day. These industries are responsible for supporting population growth, which is good. However, unlimited growth is not sustainable, so it's not really that good. What's more, the process and byproducts of deforestation are extremely harmful to our environment. Removing trees depletes the world's carbon sinks, as trees absorb more carbon than they release. It destroys habitats, which also means a loss of biodiversity. Clearing and transporting trees creates a loss of emissions, leading to an increase of greenhouse gas. This is also a repercussion of fewer carbon sinks. Deforestation also leads to less water in the atmosphere to return to the soil, disrupting the water cycle and causing soil erosion. This can cause flooding and soil contamination, potentially wasting the land that was cleared for the crops. It can also have serious implications for indigenous homeland, evicting owners from their land or disrupting the environment they depend on to sustain their way of life. These practices are outlined by the IPCC as causes of climate change and are ultimately not sustainable practices. So what can we do about it? The resounding message is better forest management is essential, along with the reduction of deforestation as a whole. Not-for-profit organisations like the Wilderness Society and Rainforest Rescue are advocating for legislation change so that laws better support the life our lives depend on. They also monitor satellite imagery and record suspicious clearing. The Victorian government currently have policies put in place to regulate the commercial practice of timber harvesting in state parks, while also providing guidelines for practice on private land. However, the deforestation industry is still having harmful effects on our planet. What we can do is spread awareness to educate Australians on the benefits of intact ecosystems, and be leaders within our own families to blow the lid off this hidden crisis and ensure we are upholding as many sustainable practices as possible.